IG, what we looking like? What we looking like, IG? Right now, all right, IG, what it's looking like? We live yet on IG?
Fill my glasses.
IG, what we doing? We live yet?
I know we live on YouTube right now. What's up, YouTube? What's going on?
Welcome to the Gary Ganew Show. What's good? What's good? Yeah, yeah. We back again. The last episode of the year. Shit is crazy. Shout out to T Nitty on the moderation. Let me know if you can hear me good, T Nitty. And yeah. Welcome to the Gary Ganew Show, y'all. IG, whenever y'all ready to get live, we gonna get live. But shout out to everybody on YouTube. If you're on YouTube right now, click that like button, click that subscribe button. If you on IG right now, hit that heart button. Let me know what's popping. But yeah, we got Ugg from the Cellar Dwellers on the show tonight. You know what I mean? Talk about the past, present, and future. All right, T Nitty said everything is good on this end. All right, that's what's up. That's what's up. I don't know what IG doing though, but we good. We good. I just want to thank everybody that's been tuning in, man. This has been a crazy, tumultuous year. This pandemic is still going on, but glory be to God, man. I'm still here. COVID-free. And I'm just trying to stay safe and keep it together, man. But we've been through a whole lot this year, man. A lot of death. But if you're here right now, man, hit that like button, hit that heart button, man, because you still gotta press on. But like I said, man, it's the last show of the year, man. Thank y'all for tuning in. Word up, we got the UG. From Cellar Dwellers. Shout out to Phantasm, the tall man. You know these guys from Good Dwellers, the Land of the Lost. You know what I mean? Perfect Match. All of that, all of that. We're going to talk about all that tonight. You know? So, you know what? Without further ado, I think we're just going to bring in my man up right now. Let me ask the brother to unmute his mic.
Yeah, we live, baby.
Yo.
Mm-hmm. We live, Gary Ganew Show. You know what it is. It's crazy right now, man. Salute, family. What's rocking?
Yo, we good. We good over here. Salute to you too, man. First of all, I want to thank you for coming on the show, man. Appreciate you, man, giving us your time tonight, man. And, you know, as I was saying to you earlier, man, I wanted to take an opportunity to give you guys your flowers. You know what I'm saying?
Because, oh, man, salute. We appreciate the love, man. I appreciate you all allowing me to even bling on your platform. And, you know what I mean? Scare the people what they, you know, what they don't know and what they already know. You know what I mean? But I appreciate you, bro, for real.
Definitely. Definitely, man. So, yo, man, let's get to it, man. You know,
We all know that you UG from Cellar Dwellers, man. But talk about your early life, man. Where you are? Where you from, bro?
I'm from Canarsie and Marcy. See, I'm rapping already. I started out in Canarsie, and my grandmother, my aunt, and them, and we had family out in Marcy, so we should stay out there. And Marcy, salute the Marcy Projects, salute the Gillenwood Projects, East 50th, Farragut. So I was back and forth between those two spots. My grandma's where I used to stay at sometimes. She was in the same building. Jay-Z was on the sixth floor. Okay. Bleak was on the second floor. My man Nike One from the Shirt Kings was next door to us on the first floor. Sauce Money was across the building in my aunt building. We was all over, you know what I'm saying? And then when I was staying in Canarsie, you know, I was running around in Flatbush and, you know, Flatbush Ed, or, you know, Special Ed, all of them, you know, they Chubb Rock, Howie T, all of them was around that area. So yeah, man. And that was my humble beginnings, man. Played Coco Calivio and Manhunt and all that, and skateboarded in the hood. First dog to skateboard in the hood. So, you know what I mean? I'm from a wide, vast upbringing. You know what I mean?
That's what's up.
Ass whippings with the bush. Get in the house before 6 o'clock.
Yeah. Hey, I'm from that same era, man. From that same era, from that same cloth, man. So I've had a lot of Brooklynites on right. this show, man. You know what I mean? I've had Prince Lowe on here.
Oh, shout out to Prince. That's my bro Ham. Prince Lowe, what up, baby?
What high school did you go to, bro?
I went to South Shore High School.
Okay.
Went to South Shore High School. I became a Decepticon in South Shore High School. Shout out to all my Decepts out there. Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, Tech from Smith & Wesson lived across the street from me. I didn't even know he was a con until we went to like a little con function. Uh-huh. Shout out to, you know what I mean? Rest in peace, Sean Price. You know what I mean? Salute the Rock.
Right. For those that don't know, real quick, man, tell the people what about the Decepticons.
Yeah, Decepticons was a big gang that terrorized New York City. All the trains, all the trains, we was on it. You know what I mean? And us and the Low Lives. Shout out to Thurston Howell and all the Low Lives. We kind of was bumping heads at one point, but then, you know, we squashed that, and we was just real wild, man. You know what I mean? Speaking of that, like me, Thurston Howell, and the Rock, this shit, a song called Lows and Cons. So, yeah, okay, so.
I gotta check for that, man.
Yes, sir.
Growing up in the crib, like what was the soundtrack like? What kind of music was you listening to back then?
My mother and pops, my mother and father, they had a lot of house parties, invited neighbors over. So it was actually a lot of old music, a lot of Al Green, Curtis Mayfield, you know, Cool and the Gang. A lot of the old soul joints was played in the house. And I was just a young boy running around, no shirt on, and Hulk draws on. Listening to music, you know what I mean? That's absorbing all the soul music, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, so you was fucking with the comics and all that back then?
Yeah, and I was definitely a Marvel fan. I like Marvel more than DC. I thought DC was a little soft.
Yeah.
I was more of a Marvel comic dude. But then I liked funny stuff like Archie. Like I used to read all a plethora of comics and, you know what I mean, and books and stuff like that. So, but I definitely was a Marvel fan for sure. I was a DC fan, but Marvel for sure.
All right.
You know what I mean? And then after that, I just got into playing Dungeons and Dragons. My next door neighbor, my man Q, rest in peace, was he was a Russian dude, lived next door to me in the hood. And I seen him in the hallway one day playing Dungeons and Dragons. I didn't know what it was. They had the character sheets and the boards and the paper, and the dungeon master had like a little shield that he would block these people from seeing the story. And I was like, yo, what's that?
This is like the early 80s.
Yeah, early 80s. And then, you know, I was like, because I was into comics, I just was drawn to that. Like, oh, this is crazy. I mean, 20-sided dice, 6-sided dice, 4-sided dice, checking for traps and all. And then I just started sitting down and playing with them. And then I got into that fantasy world, and it was over for me, bro. Over for me. I mean,
Definitely. I could tell. So I guess that's where you got your content for your rhymes and all of that.
Right. Because I used to dance because I was a hip hop dancer. I was a B-boy. I DJed. I was definitely a hip hop dancer for sure. Before or during me writing raps, I was a hip hop dancer for sure. So I was in videos and all that. And my man Gage was a rapper, and I started dancing for him. And here go my Yorkie photo bomb, chief and video bomb.
Sounds like you got a killer in there.
Yeah, man. Yorkies is just off the hook. So we had a show one night, and we was all in the limousine, and this is how I met Phantasm and Lord Have Mercy Moore. Okay. And we was in the limousine ciphering, and when it came down to me, I was just dark clouds form, went and raised my staff. They was like, so Fan was, Fan, at that time, his name was Star Child. Phantasm was like, yo, you shouldn't even be dancing, bro. People want to hear that. I was like, nah. He was like, nah, for real. And then right after that, I just started getting more calm. All right. Penning, and every time we met up, it was like, I was spit. They was like, yo. So that's how that was born. And then Phantasm kind of, he kind of attached himself to it. And Lord Have Mercy kind of attached himself to it. And we formed the group called Realm 3. And that's how the Mystics and that stuff started coming out. And we met Ant and Danny from the Lyricist Lounge. I don't know if y'all remember the Lyricist Lounge. Shout out to Ant. And Anthony Marshall and Danny Casher. Without them, there would be no Cellar Dwellers. So I'm just letting y'all know that we just started smack. Because me and Fan wasn't even a group. To be honest, Fan wasn't originally a Cellar Dweller. It was me and my man Akin
that came up with the group or something. Was that the first name of your group, or you had a couple?
That was the first name. Was called Cellar Dwellers.
Okay.
And I was with another artist named Akin, but he played football. He had got like a football scholarship overseas. So I was like, yo, bro, just go do that.
So are you secure school at this time, or are you out of high school, or where
yeah,
you
at? I'm actually out of high school at this time.
Okay.
Right? And my man went overseas, and then during the time I had met Fan, we kept in contact, and me and Fan started doing the Lyricist Lounge together on stage, and they already thought we was a group. So we was like, yo, we might as well just keep the name Cellar Dwellers, knock it out. Then we came up with the acronym of Cellar Dwellers Represent the Underground and the Basement, because we always used to be at Lord Have Mercy's house and go, and he used to stay in the basement and look like a cellar. So we was like, sweet cellar, underground hip hop, Cellar Dwellers. And that was it, man. And me and my man made history from there. You know what I mean?
All right, that's what's up. Shout out to that, man. So speak of Lord Have Mercy, for those that don't know, you're talking about Lord Have Mercy from the Flipmo Squad. Busta Rhymes and Flip Star and all Rod Digger. Y'all should know that if you don't know.
Right.
But anyway, man, so I was asking you off camera, man.
Hold on 1 second, bro, because I don't know what just happened just now. Let me just make sure. Can you still see me?
I can still see you. I can't
see you. Hold on. You can't hear me? Hold on 1 second. Zai. Oh, hold on. Zai. Hold on 1 second, bro. I don't know what just happened just now. Oh, there we go. Can you see me now?
I never lost you.
Okay, I couldn't see you, so I had to switch the screen. Back. Oh, pardon me, bro. I'm good. I got it.
Nah. You good.
I'm about to call my 17-year-old in here. He's the techie in here.
Your technician over there.
The techie in here. So.
No doubt.
But yeah, you know what I mean? So, and
I'm just gonna ask you, where'd the name come from?
Cellar Dwellers or UG?
Your name. UG.
Oh, well, UG, being that we was representing underground hip hop, I just took the U from under and the G from ground and put it together, and it was UG. And being that UG is a side fear, I was like, yo, I'm gonna make them fear my lyrics. So I had a double meaning for it, but that's what it came from, under and ground. So I just took the U from under, G from ground. UG. That's how you got it, UG.
All right. That's real dope. So, when did you guys, start taking it serious and start going to the studio and recording songs and all that?
During the Lyricist Lounge, Scott Free and Matt Light, salute to them from Loud Records. They used to come to the Lyricist Lounge frequently.
Okay.
And we went from performing at the Lyricist Lounge to hosting it.
Okay.
When we started hosting and getting busy, they came through, one thing led to another. And Free was like, yo, we're looking at y'all smashing the situation. We might want to get y'all a deal up and Loud. I was like, We was like, what? Because we was going to Stretch Armstrong, and I didn't mean to leave this out. We was smashing college radio at the same time. Stretch Armstrong and Bobbito, Underground Railroad, all these underground circuits. We was destroying them.
Going up there and freestyling?
Freestyling and destroying them. Mm. And through that vehicle and the Lyricist Lounge, the A&Rs from Loud approached us and was like, yo, listen, y'all got something we like. We starting to, you know, we at this label called Loud Records. At that time, I think it was just Mobb Deep and the Alcoholics there. Mm. It was like, we want to add y'all to the roster. We was like, what? This is what we here for, what are we talking about?
So what year was this? Not to cut you off.
That was like 94, 5, around that area.
Okay.
And we got the deal. And, you know, they brought us up to Loud and we met Steve Rifkin. And at that time, Steve Rifkin looked like something out of a surfer movie. He had long hair. He was like, oh, mm-hmm. We're going to make you guys millionaires and blah, blah, blah. We were sitting back like, yeah, okay. Because when you hear stuff like that, it's like, yeah, we got to see it first.
Was that the first time you guys had sat down with any kind of record label?
Yeah, that was the first label we sat down with was Loud Records.
Okay.
And, we were the third act signed to Loud because when we was going to Stretch Armstrong and Bobbito, Stretch Armstrong was was called Dolo Records. He was trying to put out his own record company, but at that time he was an A&R for Loud also.
Okay.
But he was trying to keep us in his pocket for his label, but he was still had to be an A&R. Like, yo, listen, I got these guys. He didn't want to really give us up. And Steve was like, nah, you crazy? We want that here. So he was like, I got to get y'all guys up. And then Scott Free and Matt, you know what I'm saying? And Matt Life took over from there. We got the deal from Loud. And we just started recording. And it took us about a year and a half or something to really get an album together. And throughout that time we was recording, Lyricist Lounge was putting out these compilation tapes called Underground Airplay. Right, Soundbomb, it was Raucous.
Oh, okay.
But Lyricist Lounge was before then. They was putting out something called Underground Airplay.
Okay.
And while we were recording stuff in the studio, we used to go to Firehouse Studios in the city. Nick Wiz came through because the Lyricist Lounge used to use his studio to record their stuff in. Mm-hmm. So they invited him to come to one of our sessions and he started just playing beats. And then he played We Got It Him. He was like, wait a minute. We need that guy on the album. You know what I mean? Right. And at the same time, us going back and forth to Lyricist Lounge, we ran into Lord Digger that was down with the Master Ace Incorporation.
Yes, sir. Okay.
And one night we was up at the Lyricist Lounge and he played Land of the Lost. Because we was up there just freestyling. He played that Land of the Lost. We was like, what?
Yeah. Now, listening to that track, it sounds like it kind of bring me to them into this same track as Smith & Wesson.
Same Jack Bruce, same record. Okay. Same exact record, just a little further down. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
We heard that. We was like, put that on a DAT and send that to us tomorrow. We going to record on that. And that's how our relationship with Lord Digger happened. And he did Land of the Lost, Realm 3. And I think that was it. And then Nick Wiz just came and he took over the whole album after that. It was crazy. And then that's how Realms of Reality formed and Voila Cellar Dwellers.
All right. So coming up, who are some of your influences that, you know, that you kind of, you know, patterned yourself after, you know, when you started?
My Uncle Kenny, rest in peace, was a DJ. Like when we was out with Marcy, they used to have Marcy Day. I used to be out there DJing goody and never bought it so black. And I used to just be sitting there like, and everybody was like, oh, I was like, that's crazy. Mm. At the same time, Cold Crush Brothers, Treacherous 3 and them was coming out there and doing stuff in the park behind my grandmother's window. They used to plug it up in the light. I used to just see how they used to just control the crowds. Like, that's crazy.
Mm.
So it kind of jumped into me from then. Then I just started, you know, my homeboys is rhyming and you should hear Special Ed and hear Kane and G-Rap and all these. I was like, yeah, I might want to get into that part of the hip hop right there. Because like I told you, I was already dancing and breakdancing and doing all that stuff already. That was just another component I wanted to add on. So yeah, once that happened, I was like, yeah, I could do this. You know what I mean? Then it was little town shows in the center and all types of stuff we was doing. And once I started seeing people yelling and screaming, I was like, all right, yeah.
It's like, yeah,
this is where I want to be at right here. Yeah.
That's what's up, man. That's what's up, man. Shout out to that, man.
So talk about the process of putting together your first album. Was that, you know, on the table as soon as you met with Loud, or did they give you like a single deal? Or
well, they gave us the album. They gave us the album deal, but they with Loud at that time, they was big on putting out singles. So they was like, we gotta get you guys a single. Because Steve Rifkin always said, oh, we're going to throw things on the wall and whatever sticks, that's what we're going to push. Mm-hmm. And we kind of felt that was the wrong way to do it because Wu and all of them came on board after that. And Wu was super huge. So it's like you throw a Wu record on the wall and throw a Dweller record on the wall and Wu was selling all these records, you're not really going to get the promotion for the Cellar Dweller album because everybody wants the Wu album. So that's how they kind of did it. So me and Fan had to rely on us going out and touring and promoting the album ourselves.
Okay.
Because the vehicle was Wu, Mob, and Pun came. And so they was going with those and didn't say, well, let's give the attention to these guys. So we had to go out there and earn our respect. You know what I mean? And that's what we did. So they gave us the album deal. We started just recording records, and landed a loss. And we got it, him and Perfect Match. They thought those was great singles, especially Perfect Match. Mm-hmm. So landed a loss, and we got it, him, got us the underground airplay, and Perfect Match took us on radio, where we got the radio play. So we was good at that point. And at that point, me and Fan didn't even care if they was pushing us or not, because we felt that we was able to go out, do these shows and promote ourselves. Mm-hmm. Now, if we wanted to, we could have easily said, we on the label with Wu, Mob, blah, blah, blah. Let's do all these features and do all that. But we didn't want to do that because we wanted this first album to just be us, where the magazines couldn't say, oh, without them, without Wu and them, this album wouldn't have been such and such. Or if this album is this single is good because it has Punisher on it. We didn't want that. We wanted it just to be us. So that's why we took that route and did it that way. You know what I mean? And we got mad respect from that, from the label and from the fans, and that's all we wanted. You know what I mean?
Right. So when you mentioned Hit the Road, was that the college tour thing?
That was a college tour where you seen us at that show in Morgan.
Yeah, so yeah, I want to share that, man, because like I was saying, the first time I saw you guys perform and it was introduced to you guys was at Morgan State University, man. You know what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Shout out to all my like I said, I believe it was you. It was Artifacts.
I think it was Bush Babies was with us. It was a couple of artists. Bella, come in.
And that was like real dope, man. Because like, you know, you had like the dreads going. You had like the whole
like the samurai cut at that point.
Yeah, the samurai dreads going on. Yeah. And just a lot of energy, man. I was like, damn, these cats is nice. And I think I had heard Realms in Reality, like I said, on the radio. But like I said, at Morgan, that was the first time I was introduced to y'all. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was a big show for us, man. Just performing at a Black College was big because the Realms in Reality attracted a lot of the college kids that the nerd core.
Mm-hmm. Especially that video.
The nerd core. And they were showing us super love. But when we was able to perform at a Black prestigious college, it's like, yo, we gotta let our people. So that show meant a lot to us. Trust me, because we was jumping out in the crowd. You remember we was out there. Like
I was giving it up. You know what I'm saying? Like I said, after it was over, y'all came on stage and y'all was back cool. Y'all was shaking hands with everybody, and I was like, yo, these are some cool cats, man. And like I said, I was saying earlier, 25 years later,
we still cooking.
You are still
cooking.
Still cooking. Still cooking.
Yeah, bro. We actually just came back like before this pandemic had hit. We was out in Bogota, Colombia. Man, I gotta send you the footage just in case you want to
put it up. I saw that. It was you and Artifacts. Yeah, you was the cameraman. You had your little camera.
Yeah, trick. heavy.
I
like,
told you, I've been watching and listening to all of your music the past few weeks, man. So yeah,
the crazy part about things like that is when people don't speak the language but they know every word. That's mind blown.
Yeah, I bet. Because like you said, you in Bogota, Colombia, that's strictly Spanish.
Nobody knows not one. You probably get a somebody that knows how to a translator to speak for you.
Right.
But when you performing, they know every single word and they saying it is just mind blowing. And I think that's what fueled us to want to make sure that our performance was top notch, because the more people want to see you, the more shows you get, more love you get, because you know what I'm saying? And like you were saying, when we hopped out in the crowd of morning, we do the same everywhere, because when people see that you are a regular person, the love is different than you being a superstar. The love is more genuine. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So we just prided ourselves on just saying what's up, shaking the hand, taking the flick, and just keep on moving instead of having security and all that. We wasn't even walking with security in none of the spots. Only one time.
With your crew, when I saw y'all pull up.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? It was only one time we had to have security. We was in Chile.
Mm.
And at that time, it was these soccer games going on, championship soccer games. So the streets was filled with soldiers, with machine guns and everything. And the promoter that brought us out there said, listen, I'm just going to tell you this right now. Whatever jewelry you got on, take it off. Whatever earrings you got on, take it off. Take that hat off. Take that bracelet off, because when you go through this crowd right here, and not to say that you guys are suckers or nothing, but I'm telling you how it is out here.
Aggressive.
You gotta take off everything or you'll come out of here with nothing. Mm-hmm. We was like, I said, you know what? You're right. So we took all our stuff, we'll put it in a safe, and the promoter had about maybe five or six guys with them, big dudes. He said, listen, the club that we were supposed to do the show in didn't have a liquor license, so your show has been canceled over there. We was like, what?
Mm.
So we was already like, just give us our money, we get on the plane. He was like, no. What I did was they wrapped the big bus with our faces on it and went to that club, picked up all the fans and brought them to the next spot. They was just going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth. But he was like, but we got another spot. Okay. But here's the bad news. The bad news is it's only one entrance and one exit. Mm. So when you get there, we got to go through one entrance. And it's the line is out there and the fans is out there. So we was like, man, all right, just taking up the jewels, taking the boxes on. So when we pulled up to the spot, the fans was all on shaking the van, everything. We was like, yo, how are we gonna get out of here? She said, don't worry about it. So he called his home, the security. They came and opened the door. He said, now get in between us and do not stop moving. I'm telling you. So we was like, all right. Mm-hmm. So they made like a barrier and just started running. While we running, Fan didn't take his do-rag off. They grabbed his do-rag. They almost pulled Fan on the floor. Now, security is knocking people out. Boom. I'm like, what's going on out here? We get up in the spot. Fan is livid. His uppies is destroyed. His do-rag is hanging over his face. And I'm like, yo, what are we? And he said, I told you. But when we got out there, it was from the booty to the tool, the top, bottom, fans all over the place. That was one of the best shows I ever did in my career. Ever did in my career.
Wow.
When we was performing, it was slam dancing. It was so crazy. The power blew out.
Wow.
We had to stop. It was pitch dark. So, you know, we Brooklyn, we backs against the wall. Like, all right, whoever coming, they getting it.
Right, right. Y'all ready.
But they turned the lights on and the fan, it was crazy, man. Crazy. So, man, I love this game. I love the game, man. And I love it just because the money is cool. We work hard. We deserve to get paid for it. But to see a fan go, wow, that's what we in it for.
Yeah.
To be able to perform and have people go. That's what we in the hip hop thing for. I don't know about everybody else, but I know for me, that's what I'm in it for. You know what I mean? The money is good, of course. It helped me support, my family. But for the fans and the crowd and people that say, yo, I listened to Realms of Reality in college and it helped me get through such and such, that's what I'm in it for, bro. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
And you could tell so, that.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
Right, definitely, man. So you talk about fans and all that stuff, man. You know, you guys were on Loud Records, man. Talk mm-hmm. about some of the label mates that you had again, man. You had Mobb Deep.
Wu-Tang Clan.
The roster was crazy, man.
We had Mobb Deep, Wu-Tang, Big Pun, Dot X, The Alcoholics, Funkmaster Flex had something on there. Dark Mind was on there. Dead Prez was on there. We was on there. We had the roster. They lucky. They very, very lucky that we put a whole Loud tour together.
Yeah, that would have been shutting crazy. Things
down.
That would have been crazy.
We toured with everybody. We did shows with everybody. Mobb, I got so much stories with Mobb and Wu and the Licks is retarded.
Yeah.
it's crazy. Like we be on here until tomorrow.
Yeah,
just wild, funny stories. Like even with Wu, like we went on tour. This was like around the time. Like we toured with Wu, like into the 36 Chambers. But when Ray's album came out,
okay,
and we was on tour. Ran Ghost. We got stories about them. That's just hilarious. That's why I say I had to do that record because Ghost is one of my top MCs ever. Just because of his whole swag, how he put words together. Mm-hmm. And when we was on tour, those was our uncles. They watched over us, made sure we ain't getting into nothing. When press and fans was acting crazy, they, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, yeah, man. Meth, rest in peace, Dirty. Those is like our uncles on the road. So we had a ball, man. We had a ball with it. You know what I mean? A ball. So
definitely. Yeah, man. Also, as I'm listening you know, to your music and getting refamiliarizing myself with Realms in Reality.
Right.
I also came across a group of albums called Cellar Sounds by Nick right. Winters.
Yeah.
And bro, it was just, I don't know, it's like 40 songs on each joint. It was like when I'm you know listening and doing and looking through y'all files, I come across that like that was a whole nother pot of gold, son.
Crazy. Nick Wiz, that's my brother. Me and Wiz, throughout this journey of music, we became family. Fan too, we became brothers. He's the one that taught me. Him, my manager, shout out to my manager, AD, and my man Quan. Those are the ones that really taught me how to make beats. But Wiz, in specific, taught me how to use the machine. And Wiz is just a stand-up dude. He's very humble. He don't like no crowds. He don't mm-hmm. like no cameras. He don't like no interviews. So I got to pull Wiz out to do stuff. But just working with him was just amazing because his knowledge of music and the things that he did with that SP while we was making those albums and just the things that he do with music now is just amazing, man. I just want to salute my bro Nick Wiz because he's a very, very important tool in the Cellar Dwellers lineage. Let me say that. And the Cellar Sounds is just joints we never released. We recorded it at his house.
But it's so many. It's so many songs.
He worked with everybody.
I see that. He got a song with Rakim on there.
He did the Seventh Letter. He worked with everybody. And he also did stuff for Disney. Mm. He did Spectrum commercials, wow. Michael Jordan stuff. So he's just, I'm saying, and outside of all of that, the core of it is he's just a stand-up dude. Like when I was learning how to make beats, I would call him at all kinds of times at night and he wouldn't be beefing and say, yo, bro, it's 3 a.m, I'll call you tomorrow. He would say, yo, I'm turning my machine on now. What's the problem? And I would tell him and he's just that type of dude. So salute to my bro, Nick Wiz, man. Yes, just making this metabolic project was just crazy working with him. So that's my bro, man. He been through it all. he was out there in Chile when them lights went out and we was walking through that crowd. He'd tell you. You know what I'm saying? He wanted to actually hop in on the Zoom. You know what I'm saying? But I was like, I don't know. I got to ask Gal.
Oh, no, bro. It would have been a pleasure, man. That make it even more real. You know what I'm saying?
I'm about to call him in a second. I'm going to give him the code. He's going to pop in on here. You know what I'm saying? But Nick Wiz is, it's just amazing, man. He's you know what I'm saying? He's a stand-up dude. His parents allowed us to come into the studio and make noise all kinds of night and come down and feed us. And it, you know what I mean? That's my bro, so. Yeah, man, I'm gonna hit him up and see if we want to pop ahead. But the Cellar Sounds is just amazing. That's why we went on tour, because we did the tour with him doing the Cellar Sounds and us doing the album.
Okay.
It was crazy. Crazy.
Yeah, crazy. That was like I said, a lost treasure. Like I had no idea that it even existed. And then for it to be so much music, I was just like, yo, and just the beats and every, oh man, it was just so.
He got a truckload, bro. Wiz got a truckload of stuff.
I see.
Let me see if I could catch it. He got a truckload. Let me see if I can get it. He got a truckload. Let me see if he answers the phone.
All right, it's all good. It's all
but
good.
But he's definitely logging in. Let's see if I can get him.
No doubt. Shout out to everybody watching right now. Like I said, we are live with Ugg from the Cellar Dwellers.
Yes, sir. The Gary Gnu Show, man. I'm privileged to be here. Look at that. I want to show you. Let me make sure his number ain't showing.
Lock the number. Yeah,
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system.
He ain't picking up. Yeah. I'm going to text him. Yeah, but I'm going to get him to pop on here before it's over.
It's all good, man. So, yeah, like I said, as I'm watching your video, Land of the Lost remind me of that game. Remember that game Tomb Raider?
Yes.
The computer, I was like, wow, these niggas had computer graphics. Like, what year was that, 96 or something?
96.
Like
imagine now. Imagine if we had the technology that the tech right now. Do you know how?
That's kind of what I'm doing now. I mean, because it looked like you guys were just on like on a green screen. You know what
that's
I'm saying?
That's it, right.
But now it's like, it's nothing for me to do this shit now. But at that time period,
right, it was right, unheard of. You know what I mean? I wish, bro, that I knew what I knew now, I wish I'd have knew it back then, because now it's like, you look at yo, Wizzo.
Yes, sir.
Yo, I'm on the Gary Gnu Show right now. I'm going to send you the Zoom code. We need you to hop on here, bro. All right,
send it to me.
All right, cool. I'm going to send it to all you right now.
Okay.
I told you I'm going to get him. I told you I'm gonna get him.
This is golden right here.
Yeah, I told you I'm gonna get him. You know what I mean? Right. It's hard to get him. It's hard to get him on stuff, but I got him. I got him, bro. It's over.
Somebody in the comments said, shout out to OZ Gray. He said the Dwellers were criminally underrated. Not only
that's a snapper top fact.
Not only dope tracks, their low game was on 100. Peace to Ugg and Phantasm. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The perfect match video.
Oh, now we was lit. They don't even know the half, bro. They don't even know the half of the situation. We
had a lot of cameos in there too. You had Tech was in there.
Yeah, we had Tech in there. My man, the guy that said, yo, you brought that gift, you deserve to be played. That was my right hand man. Okay. Dog, he just passed away, bro.
Oh,
his last show was the 25th anniversary. We took all kinds of pictures.
Damn.
Yeah, bro. Yeah, that was, you know what I'm saying? That hit me kind of hard, bro, because that was my dog. Like, me and him, we beat up people fought.
Right.
You know, types of stuff, bro. So
I figured that had to be like your mans and them. Like, anybody that had a little part like that had to be like your strong people.
No, snap with top fat.
Not just random, you know what I mean?
Yeah, nah, hold on.
Shout out to Drazmatic that just joined on IG. Peace.
Draz, what up? What's good with your family?
Shout out to everybody that's watching.
Yeah, I'm sending it to him now, bro. So
okay.
He gonna pop one here in a minute.
All right.
Yeah, man. But like I said, bro, I just wanna salute you again for just allowing me to I mean, just
man, it's my pleasure. You a legend. And like I said, we need to show our legends and let people know who you are. You know what I mean?
No doubt.
My man in the comments said that second album was fire. Yeah, man. The last Shall Be First.
Yeah, that album we started branching out.
After the first joint, it was a big gap between that. Any reason for that?
Yeah, that gap was because Loud created a subsidiary label called Stimulated Loud.
That was during the big right. label change and all that. The label.
Right. So at that point, Steve was like, "You know, we got to get you guys some attention. So we created a subsidiary called Stimulated Loud. We're gonna put y'all over there." And we went over there, and that was the gap, just that label forming and us waiting and getting the budget to record. And that was the big gap. Dante Ross ran that label.
Okay.
I mean, he had Whitey Ford and all of them over there. And then we went over there, and that's when The Last Shall Be First was born. And we said, yo, this time around, we're going to get some features. So that's why you hear Organized Confusion on there. Speck Dex on there. Why you hear those type of, yes. Smith the Cocoa Bees is on there. Large Pro is on there. So, switch hit me right now.
Send me. Only thing I didn't like was I wasn't able to find it on Apple Music. I had to pull it up on YouTube. So I didn't know the track titles and you know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
But that album was fire too, because you also had that, The Main Aim.
Yeah, oh man, that was off the
Yo, and when y'all performed that live, I was like, ooh, y'all murdered listen, that live.
Yeah, that was our first soundtrack. That's why you hear fans say, I never did a soundtrack. Yo Wizzo, what you need, bro?
I just need the link. You sent me like a copy of screenshot.
Right, on the link is in there. The link is in there.
Yeah, but it's a screenshot. I can't click the link.
Got you. No problem. I'm sending it to you right now.
Just hold the link down.
Got you. I got you.
Send it in the text.
I got you. All right.
Yeah, you got the text. He's giving you the text.
Yeah, he's trying to show me how to send it and send the link down. And I got you, bro. I thought I just did that. But yeah, bro, that was our first soundtrack. You know what I mean? And
On Soul in the Hole.
Soul in the Hole.
Yo, and also, like I said, you know, digging up y'all shit, I listened to that soundtrack. I was like, oh, God.
Yeah, man.
So much hate on there, bro.
And when we saw who he was on there with, we was like, what?
And you could tell everybody, was like, yo, we got to do our best shit. Because you had Brand Nubian on there, Smith & Wesson was on there, you guys was on there.
Everybody.
Big Pun.
Yes, sir.
Had a song on there. That soundtrack was fire. I don't even remember seeing the movie, but the soundtrack itself was fire. You know what I mean?
Yeah, bro. That main soundtrack.
Main Aim, man.
That's it. Let me tell you, that record. When we did that record, that's when the people up in Loud, like Woo and all them, was like, yo, we see y'all.
Yeah.
Like, we see what y'all doing. We was like, yeah, we trying to do it. You know what I mean? We working. We trying to figure it out. They was like, nah, we see y'all. I was like, all right, well, as long as y'all see us, yeah. We good from there. You know what I mean?
Yeah, that was.
I'm sending this link right now. He ready to be here. Let me share this link with Nick Wizzle. He gonna pop on here in a minute.
All right, salute.
Yeah, bro, we have
ball, man. Like you know, 2/3 of the cellar dwellers. That yo,
I should call Fan now. See if I can get him.
Oh God, if you get Fantasm,
Let me see if I can get him. He on vacation too, but he'll pop.
Don't don't disturb.
No. He for this, he'll get on here. He'll get on. Let me see if he feels.
Wow. Yo, I hope see y'all
that? Look at that. Witness. Look at that. Look at that.
I hope y'all. Wow, y'all see that? You see that?
Yo,
Fan.
Hey, yo, Fan.
Yo.
I'm doing a Zoom interview with my man Gary Ganu.
Okay.
Can we get you to pop on for a quick second? Right this second.
Okay.
All right, one.
Real shit.
See what I'm saying, bro?
Y'all see this?
See what I'm
saying? Are y'all see this?
See what I'm saying?
Oh, my gosh.
Let me make sure I got him. Let me get him, bro. See what I'm saying? Yeah, he with it. Get him right at home. Yeah, no. Let me send him the link. Open. Let me share it to him. Phantasm. See if he got that link. Let's see if they pop on here, bro. See if I'm doing it right.
I'm waiting. I'm waiting to see. I'm waiting to see
if I'm doing it right. Yes, sir. Okay. Yeah, all they got to do is open it up. Let's see if they get on here. But yeah, so I'm going to try to see if I can get them all on here. If all I can get Nick Wiz and Fan on here, then it's over.
We'd have the whole cellar dwelling.
Come in. Come, honey. Come, just say hi. My wife, that's my biggest supporter, man. She changed my life, bro.
Shout out to wifey. You need a strong woman in your corner, man.
See, that's what I'm saying. He said, come in real quick. Don't worry about your hair, man. Keep that dude on.
This is Phantasm right here. This is Chris. Yeah,
that's him. Get him in there. Come back real quick.
Lord. Ladies and gentlemen.
Phantom, look, this is my wife right here. Say what up.
Hey, how you doing? Nice to meet you.
Yeah, there you go. I told you, we're going to turn it. We're going to get it crazy.
Wifey on here like, this is the moment right here.
We're going to get it crazy in here.
This is the moment.
Get it crazy. Yeah.
About to get it popping.
Yes, sir. That's what we're here for.
You need me to pull?
Wow.
No, Wiz is on. Wiz give me a come on right now.
I want to let y'all know right now, IG, YouTube, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, hit that heart button. Yeah. We are about to have both of the cellar dwellers on the Gary Gnu Show. Yeah. This is what we talk about.
I told you when
hip hop.
When UG come on here, we make fireworks happen, man. It's 4th of July all over again. You know what I mean?
Shout out
to Gary Gnu again for letting us be able to just get on a platform and bling, man.
Definitely, man. Definitely. Yeah. Hold on, let me see. Is he having problems with his audio?
You have a problem? Come on, let me get Wiz again, too. Make sure I get Nick Wiz right in here.
Come on, y'all. Let me see. But this is it right here.
See
what I said? You see what I told you? I got my PNC on here. What we talking about?
What we doing?
Yo, Phantasm, I want to welcome you to the Gary Gnu Show, man. Yes, sir. I appreciate you, man, coming on, man. You know, I've been chopping it up with your man, and right. I've been, you know, he's giving you guys your flowers. I know you guys just celebrated 25 years of the release of Realms and Reality.
Yes, sir.
And yes, sir. Like I said, man, it's a blessing that you guys are still here. You guys are still making music. I was telling earlier how I was, I just watched your video. For zero fucks.
Right.
My PNC getting busy, man.
That's fire, man. So, yo, I'm just glad to have you here, man. How you doing, bro?
I'm good, man. By the grace of God, we still here. We still doing it. So, you know, I'm good, man. Everything's good right now.
All right. How does it feel, you know, 25 years later to still be able to go out and perform classic music that you created? You know, when you was a child, basically, you know,
right,
what I mean?
Right.
You was a youth.
It feels good, man, that the music is still appreciated after all these years. You know what I'm saying? Me right. and my man, we take pride in real lyrics and real bars. So
exactly.
That the stuff, the hard work that we put in, it still matters to this day, and we still love for those records. There's a lot of groups that can't go out on stage and do what we do right now because those records don't translate over that period of time.
Facts. I was just telling him too, PNC, we just did a new record, so they better get ready.
Oh yeah, they better get ready. We coming again.
Yeah.
I feel like the OGs is bringing back the lyricism, they bringing back the beats, they bringing back just the whole aesthetic that I feel like hip hop has been missing, man. Like I said, you guys are legends in this game, man, and it's really like an honor to have you both here. Here's Nick Wiz. Hold on.
There we go. We locked in. This is it. The band is here.
We are 3 for 3 tonight.
Woo. That's what happened, man. I bring the family, man. The family come in and we make sure everything go right.
Phantasm, where you at right now, though, Phantasm?
I'm out here in Vegas right now. You know what I mean?
I see the buildings.
Trying to come up big in these casinos, but they beating me down. So I had to get up out of there.
Get that money. Let's go.
I'm trying to come up, but they
you see who that is right there? What we talking about?
Yo, Nick Wiz, Gary Gnu, man. Nice to meet you, man. It's a pleasure to have you on the show. I know that you are very humble, low key brother, behind the scenes brother. But I know that you are the mastermind to a lot of production from these guys and numerous other artists, man. So, you know, I just want to give a salute to you, man.
Yes, sir.
Appreciate you, man. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Can y'all hear me?
Yes, sir.
We hear you loud and clear.
All right, good, good, good. All right, cool.
Yeah, so I was telling Ugg earlier when I was, you know, when I was going back and refamiliarizing myself with their catalog and their music, I came across a series that you put out called Cellar Sounds.
Correct.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And it's a series of underground, like, I mean, I don't know if anybody else out there has heard, but I've never even heard these joints. So when I found them, it was like the super pot of gold, like the super Easter egg, like, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, that was just like, dude, that was work that over the years of working with Dwellers, like songs that didn't even make it to albums, you know.
Go ahead. Every track on there is fire though. Like every beat on there bangs. It's just like boom, bap. You know what I mean? Like, oh my God.
Appreciate that, man. Thank you.
You know, how do you feel after all these years, man? 20, you know, you guys just celebrated 25 years of Realms and Reality, and you've also collaborated and produced, Metabolic and all that. How does it feel to, you know, to still be in the game and still have an audience out there that appreciates your sound?
I mean, listen, it's a beautiful thing, you know. This is why we did it. I mean, we did it. We love music, man. So, you know, not only that, you know, we just wanted to get what we was thinking, what we was trying to create out to the masses, you know. So that's like, you know, that's like a great opportunity for when you actually have a platform to be able to release all this stuff, you know. So and people appreciate it.
No doubt. When you guys are in the studio creating, is it a situation where you guys already know what you're going to say to the track, or you give them a beat and they go home and write to it, or how does your recording process go usually?
He gives us the beat, and then me and Fan, we go home and just stitch the clothing to it. You know what I'm saying? Come back in, lay it down. Wiz, like I was telling you before, why I respect him. Wiz is the type of person that'll tell us, go back in there, because that ain't it.
Okay.
That need more energy.
I got some damn nerve.
Lay that down. That's how it is. You know what I mean? Am I lying, PNC? Or Fan?
So he definitely.
You guys ever like bump heads, you know what I'm saying?
Of course. That's a part of the process though.
Yeah.
So we bumped heads, but it was for a good reason.
Exactly.
And I ain't pausing, I ain't doing none of that because niggas is grown. You know what I'm saying? At the end of the day, if it ain't right, he'll say, yo, go back in there. If it ain't right, Fan will tell me to go back in. If I ain't right, I'll tell him to go back in. And it's just, you know what I mean? We just respect that. And that's what makes those classics happen, you know what I mean?
Exactly. Right. That's what keeps it sharp, too. That's what keeps it sharp and egos out the way.
Yeah, facts.
Yeah. Speaking of sharp, man, I was telling Ugg earlier, man, when you guys were on stage performing, I watched that 25th anniversary. You guys were like sharp as iron, like the way you still were spitting with that same energy. Because I was telling Ugg, the first time I saw you guys perform was at Morgan State, man, back in 95.
Crazy.
Oh yeah.
That's my first time being introduced to y'all, man. Nick Wiz, man, who was some of the producers that you looked to when you were coming up, man?
Pete Rock, definitely, man. Pete Rock was one of them. Easy Mo B, Premier. You know, I mean, those are my three favorites. You know what I'm saying? And right now, if I pick one, it'd be Needles. My man Needles, and he nice as hell, man.
All right. That's what's up, man. So you have a particular machine that you use throughout the time, or you switch it up, you know what I mean?
It's definitely switched it up. It was the SP 950.
Uh-huh.
Dipped and dab with the MPC wasn't my favorite. You know, SP was my baby, you know. So but then I went off into the machine world, you know, Native Instruments machine. And
hello.
I've been there ever since, man, because I actually got all my SP-1200 sounds inside the machine.
Okay. That's how you were able to still, I guess, maintain those, you know, that same sound, you know, with the production.
Somewhat.
You know what's so crazy about that, Gary? We went to Wiz's house and me and Ben was working on a record over there, a record or two. And Wiz pulled that machine out. We seen all them lights. We was like, ooh, what's that? Yeah. He was like, yo, this is a machine, yo. You gotta go get one. Next day or maybe like the next week, I was like, yeah, I need that. I took pictures of the box, sent it to Wiz, like, yeah, I got that machine, bro. What's going on? What's going on? Fan got his joint.
Okay. Okay. Crazy, so, I guess both of you guys produce too as well. Fan, you produce beats too as well.
Yeah, you make beats. Okay. Don't let Fan sit over here and be quiet about that. Fan make beats.
I think his screen is frozen. Fan,
you frozen, there? Bro?
Yeah, Fan. You?
Oh, yeah.
I think he froze up.
He's in the basement of a casino right now.
Yeah. He's in the cellar. He's in the cellar in the casino right now.
Pulling them slot machines.
Yo, it looks like he's just so focused on the machine right now. So I got the bonus.
Oh no.
Yeah, man. So since we have you here, man, I also listened to your joint, your solo joint, Portals.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Nick, I know you did a few tracks on there, right?
Nah. B-sides and remixes. Oh, nah? No, B-sides
and remix for him, though.
Yeah, he did remixes, yeah. B-sides
okay. Remixes. Uh-huh. Talk about making that, and what was it like to do an album without your partner in rhyme?
To be honest with you, Portals was actually about we was putting little things together. Portals was about maybe 7 years old. And we just sitting there.
Really?
And I was like, all right, well, me and my man ID, shout out to Creative Juices Music. He was like, let's put it out.
Mm-hmm.
We put it out. That Super Duper Love, we was like, all right, let's put out some B-sides and remixes. Put them out, called up the team, called Wiz up, blah, blah, blah. We did, and it was dope, man. You know what I'm saying? And that was like, because I've been talking about doing a solo joint. Like, I've been to Wiz Studio trying to put solo joints together for the longest. That just happened to be the first one that come out. You know what I'm saying? Or it came out. And after that, Metabolic was rocking after that. We was like, okay. And how Metabolic came about, we sent me a record called Step 2. We was saying, yo, we gonna just put a record out. We were talking about an album or nothing. Because actually it was supposed to be an EP, and Wiz gonna verify this. He always get on me about this. It was only supposed to be 8 records.
Really?
Right?
I think it's 10 on there.
Exactly. There's 10 on there.
It's only supposed to be 8 records. So Wiz sent me a beat. He sent me something called Step 2.
Okay.
There you go, Fan back in the building.
I'm here.
Me and Wiz was just talking about putting out a single. Right? So he sent Step 2 to me. I sent them the verses back probably like in the next 2 days with the hook on it. And we was like, yo, you know what? We might as well just do an EP. So in the process of us doing that EP, my pops caught COVID at that time. And I was just downloading stuff out the air because I had to kind of try to take myself out of the sorrow of that while he was in the hospital. So while Wiz was sending them to me, I was just downloading stuff. I didn't know how it was just coming, writing, send them a record back, produce one, do the hook, do the beat, send them. And that process was a healing process or a safe place process for me during that time.
Right.
And Wiz was just so patient because he understood. He didn't rush me to do nothing. He didn't rush me to write nothing. But he didn't have to because through that tragedy, it forced me to write. You know what I'm saying?
I'm with you.
It forced me to write stuff. And Metabolic was done in a rapid time. You know what I'm saying? So that's how that came about. And then we finished 8 records. And then I did 2 more. And I kind of slipped them in there. Wiz was like, I thought we were doing 8 records.
What was the last 2 that you slipped on there, that you slipped in there?
I think it was
my favorite Thanos.
Thanos.
Okay.
And I think Thanos and the fans record.
Uh-huh.
Thanos and Back to Work. I said we gotta do these 2. Okay. So Wiz is like, I see what you're doing.
Back to work.
This is it. This is it right here. This is it. And that's how Metabolic came. So salute to him and my PNC for putting in the work to get on that. Cause I kind of try to put pressure on Fan. to write to that. I said, yo, fam, we only got a week, bro. The album is done, right? So we only got a week, bro. You gotta get that done, bro. I need that. So fam wrote, he wrote a couple of verses. The first one he wasn't comfortable with. Went back in, pinned it, got crazy. Back to Work is ready. That's the next video.
Okay, yeah, I like that. That's the last joint on the album.
Yeah, I had to get my PNC on it.
You got a posse cut on here called Kill Switch, man. Talk about that, man. Putting that together. Shabam Sadiq, Rusty Jux. You know what I mean? D.V. Elias Christ.
Skanks, Man of Medicine, Joe Pesci.
Yeah.
I always wanted to do a posse cut. Always wanted to do one of those. I said, I'm going to just put a couple of people together and knock it off. Actually, Fan was supposed to be on that, but I wanted Fan to be on the record with me because it was more sentimental than just him being on the record with everybody. I said, let the Dwellers do a record.
Yeah,
so when we shoot that video, it's just like Dwellers. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Because I shot him the beat. He sent me a verse. I said, you know what? I'm going to put him on something else. Right. I wanted to be the Dwellers. And that's how that came about. I called everybody up. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yo, I need you. Sent them the beats. There's no problem. They sent me the verses back 2 or 3 days. And somebody caught me for that Kill Switch hook, actually, because me being gung-ho, I was on live doing a hook, and somebody caught me for it slightly. But I ain't going to say nothing.
Really?
But they caught me for it. But we still doing that. So there's nothing they can do about that. We're shooting a video for that. It is what it is. You know what I mean? Figure it out after that.
One of my favorite joints on there is a joint called Spit Darts. And it's a song where you owe to Ghostface. And I was talking to you earlier because I said, yo, when I first started listening to it, I instantly thought back to Cuban Link when Ghost was like, yo, I want niggas sound like me on no album. You know what I mean? And yeah, then he go up with the whole, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, but talk about uncles, how that came about though, bro. That's a fire song, man.
Those is our uncles anyway. Like, we was on the road with Van Ghost. They had me and Fan drunk in the bar somewhere, twisted. Those is our uncles. They always took care of us. They always showed super love. It was never no, we better than y'all. They respected us because the lane that we took was different from what everybody else was doing. When we put songs like Advance the Boardwalk and all that together, they was like, yo, we loving them. Like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I just was like, yo, Ghost is one of my favorite artists.
All right.
It's just his swagger, what he be saying, his whole, the whole lingo, everything just reminds me of like a futuristic pimp. You know what I mean? Somebody, it just reminds me of that. So
yeah.
I was like, yo, I'm going to do something that's different because Ace already did Me in the Biz.
Right, right.
So I said, I'm a up it and I'm going to do Me and Ghost.
Yeah.
And like I said, Ghost is one of my artists. I listen to him all the time. So for me to do that record, I had to kind of listen to a bunch of Ghost records and then kind of put myself in that pocket.
Right.
And say, yo, I'm going to challenge myself to get in Ghost pocket and started knocking it out, went to Wiz house, recorded it. That was it. I was like, yeah, this is it right here. You know what I'm saying? And I'm getting super love. Everybody's like, yo, that you in Ghost pocket right there. Like, it sounded like Ghost on that one. That's what I wanted to do.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Gotta spit your dogs.
You gotta spit your dogs. You know, he's stretching out. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yeah, man. So that was a special record for me, like I said, because I was able to be multi IDs, be myself and be Ghost at the same time. And I was saying to myself, how am I going to match that and make it mesh? Yeah. And like I said, by the grace of God, it came together, bro. You know what I mean? No, we shooting a video for that, too.
I hope so, man.
Oh, no, it's going to be crazy. We already locked in with that. And we already locked in with that.
Also, the joint White Run. That's another one of my favorites, man, because that's straight up on some like Game of Thrones. You riding on the dragon and you put your foot on the back of his head. You know what I mean? The blade hums and like, yo, when you're flying on a dragon, you can hear the wind and shit. I'm like, oh, this fucking song is intense, man. What was the, you know what I'm saying? What was the inspiration for that song, bro?
I told Wiz I wanted to do another Mystical record.
Yeah.
And when he sent that beat, mm-hmm. I was like, so it was a game I played called Skyrim.
Okay.
Playing a role-playing game. And in that game was a town called Whiterun, where all these wizards and war, they all met and the guilds was all in there. So I said, you know what? Being already, we had the Mystical Journal Smash. I said, I'm going to try to create a visual comic book of a story. Mm-hmm. So me hearing the beat alone is like, okay. Because sometimes with me, the beat tells me what to do. It puts me in that zone. And when I heard the track from Wiz, I was like, oh yeah, this gotta be. I gotta put a story together in 3 verses. Mm. So that was the most challenging part. But we used to doing that. Like, I played the game, so I'm used to doing that. And I started the first story started off with the dude approaching the guild and all of that, and people seeing who he was, which is kind of like the story in Skyrim. Then riding a dragon and all that just started falling out the air for me. I'm not even gonna lie to you. That data just started falling out the air for me. After the first verse was done, data started falling.
Super duper creative, man.
You know what I mean? We need a cartoon for that. We trying to get somebody to shoot it.
Yeah.
That.
That'd be crazy.
Yeah. Because it definitely, it you was in the same, that, you know, in that cellar dweller lane, like, you know, like that,
yeah.
That shit that y'all talk about, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. That song just embodied all of that to me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Yo, right about now, I want to show one of you guys' old videos, and then I want to bring you up to show the video for Metabolic, man.
Okay.
But I think I want to go with I love Good Dwellers, but I like Perfect Mask. I like all y'all, you know what I'm saying? But I think I'm gonna go with Perfect Mask because y'all had that low on, you know what I mean, in that video, man. You know, talk about shooting that. If you could take us back to, you know, because like I said, you got a lot of cameos in there. Take us back to those times.
Talk to him, PNC. Or he went off. Well, we shot Perfect Match actually in a CBS studio in the city. We wanted to do a talk show thing, and yeah, Ricky like, Lake like at that Ricky time Lake was popping. Type thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Right, she was popping at that point.
I'm with you.
So we just took that. Idea and just ran with it. We had tech in there from Smith & Wesson. His cameo was in there. What's going on over here, bro? Hold on.
No. He's changing. I think he's gonna play something.
Oh, Wiz, I was about to say, what's going on over here?
Nah. I'm sharing.
PNC, he was asking us how that Perfect Match video came about, and, you know, what the process was.
Started with the beat. With the beat. The beat was just crazy, and we knew. Once he played that melodic track, we knew we had to come. We knew we had to come girly on that one.
All right.
And he was just saying, how you know, as far as the video, you know, how did we, you know, how the video was shot? What was the vibe through that? You know what I mean, in and out of that video. You know what I mean, shooting that video at CBS Studios. We had, matter of fact, Nick Wiz was in that video.
Yeah, he was there with us.
Yeah, I was.
That's when the talk show stuff was popping. So we just wanted to do the follow up with the Ricky Lake concept. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Shorty tried to play both of us. So we went on the show. We found out she was trying to run around both of our backs.
Yeah. So, that's what I always liked about y'all songs, like that. You guys always told a nice story, you know what I'm saying? With the L twist at the end and shit.
Exactly. Yep.
Brady Wolf.
My bad. Hold on, y'all. There we go. Damn.
All
right, so ladies and gentlemen, this is Perfect Match by the Cellar Dwellers.
Yes, sir.
Welcome back. Our next guests are two guys who claim they got played by the same girl just because they're rappers. Please help me welcome Fan and Up.
Easy.
City. After you poop, my attitude is real.
scream Lex with the jacks. You got the black tennis skirts. The Vince Smith about the South Six. Jewel cheeky eyes long.
The Mecca.
The leg and the thigh stick like she ran traps. For what it's worth, Shorty was made from the best things on this earth. Like a snap. Want to drink them to quench my thirst. Jump in the coupe and do my joint in reverse. Hey, boo, I was watching you.
I was watching you.
Here's my number. True. Call me at the crib at 2.
What do you think?
Hey, yo, tell me what went wrong to make me write the song. Used to have it going on. Our feelings were so strong. Your age 26, my number one draft pick. From all the rest, got first dibs. Plus your own crib, you just flew back in town. Where's son? Dallas. And says she wants the tall man to come to her palace. I'm over there tonight to watch the Bulls catch mix from the Knicks. And at halftime, I watch Rod Strips give his an engine. I feel lucky to shoot this ism in the triangle of prism in out in Bed-Stuy. Come on now, baby, cause I'm packing. I got the phone call at 2. It's me, boom, oh. She said, you know, why don't you come to the river? We can wine and dine and relax on the low. And drink more, by the way, I just saw you.
Here we go.
Give me your house, jump out the shower, and bury my body.
And yeah, you really buried yourself in that baby powder, yo.
Oh, yeah, we put what's extra up? Holes in that.
Oh,
oh, that was real. That wasn't a stunt man right there. That was me right there.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
You're treating that girl like she's a piece of meat. You deserve it. So tell us, guys, what happened?
Terrible, man. She played it.
Wait in the living room, be back real soon. On HBO tonight, it's a tune. Lay back in this recliner, set on my mind. Playing pity pat, watching Fritz and Cat. In the driveway, through on the clock, playing knives on love. Drinking on each, so me.
See that? Try.
Right.
Talking on myself. To the back and see black night, smell Fahrenheit. That's when Shorty took flight. What's the deal, fam? What's the real plan? Shorty flashed.
That she bounced on me like that?
Mm-hmm.
Got my man in the back. Look at that.
Wanted us to be one.
Terrible, bro.
He trying to hide the fly.
Terrible, bro. Terrible.
A little bit too fast for me. What do you guys think? Should we give her a chance to defend herself?
Look at that. Heartbroken, dude. She broke
like
my heart.
Was that Blase Blase?
Nah, Blase wasn't.
Okay, my bad.
That was produced by Nick Wiz, too. You know that, right?
Oh, yeah.
Nah,
yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Hey man, you guys give y'all putting me on. That's what's up.
See,
man.
Yeah, where's produced that? Nick, where's produced that? My stock went up after that video, bro.
Oh yeah,
my stock went up.
And 25 years later, we still rocking.
Look at that. You
low,
see that? Bro. You see that?
Mm-hmm. Huh? I see that.
What you talking about? Look at him. Look at him, champ.
Hey,
look at him.
Two L's, baby.
Look
two
at him,
L's.
We still doing it. You know what I mean? Huh? So
I know, man. That's what's up, man. Oh, Phantasm. Talk about you know, some of the stuff that you're working on right now, bro.
Did a whole bunch of features. Started doing a solo project off and on. I like some joints. I don't like some joints. I'm real critical on myself. So plus the general, he set the bar mad high with that portal. So I had to make sure whatever I do after that.
Yeah. So, that portals was fire.
Yeah. So we still working on some joints. I got a couple joints in the stash, and then I'm still waiting on some features too. When you ain't got that kind of bread to pay people out, you got to wait on their time, and then I get frustrated. Niggas don't hit you back in time. How you waiting around? And it's like a start over pause process. So we'll see what happens.
I feel you, man. I just want to say, the only difference between that video and you guys now is the haircuts, man.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, man.
You see that's me, it. Bro. You see me. I got the Terry Crews under here, bro. You see me. Let me just say something right now. Me and my PNC just did a new record.
Oh, yeah. Today.
We're about to do an EP, man. It's going down. We already spoke about it.
All right.
Wade said y'all need to stop playing, so we ain't going to play around with it. We're going to do it,
man. I can't wait to hear it, man. The hip hop needs that. Hip hop needs that.
Definitely.
For real, for real. So yeah, man. I want to get into the video for Metabolic 2 right now, man. Talk about that's the first single off the album. First of all,
yes, sir.
Talk about the title Metabolic. For those that don't know what that means, what does that mean, bro?
Let me just give you a little backstory. After Wiz sent me Step 2 and we decided to do the project, that was the second beat he sent me.
Okay.
And in that beat, you hear that lady saying Metabolic.
Yeah.
I was like, that's the name of it right there. And then I came up with an acronym for it. It's like music elevates the average brain over lyrics or loops incredibly crafted.
Wow.
Woo.
I didn't even know that. You just did some old main source breaking Adam shit.
I was just thinking about it. I said, we're going to name the album Metabolic. So that's why I was saying music elevates the average brain over loops, or you could say lyrics incredibly crafted.
Damn.
Wow. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. I like that.
After that beat came and we did that, everything else just started falling in place, man. We started just Jenga and taking pieces out until it fell and everything was done. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just privileged to have my PNC on that album, because a lot of people always say, yo, what y'all doing? So to get him on there was dope. To get Jabam on there was dope. Rusty Jokes, Skanks, Main the Medicine, Born Unique, Pesci, yep, and DBLS Christ on that project.
Right.
And my man Lavelle on that project was dope. You know what I mean? And just to even be able to share production with Wiz was just a dream come true for me, bro, because I watched him make so many records and we just been through so many things in life and becoming family. It was dope just to be able to share platform as far as production on a project with him. You know what I'm saying?
Which joints did you produce?
I did Spit Darts.
Okay.
I did Get It In.
All
right. I did Go Stupid. I did the joint with me and Fan, which is called Back to Work.
Yeah.
I did Thanos.
Get It In.
And I did Get It In. Yeah.
Well, that sound like more than half the album, right?
Yeah, because it was supposed to only be 8. But that's why the last two came. And Wiz is like, it was supposed to be 8, but it wound up turning out great. So know what I mean, so
I just wanted to get it out. You know what I'm saying?
Not like, get it in. He's like, I wanted to just get it out.
Hold on, Wiz. I got two more, man.
That's what's up. It's dope to see, man. Like I said, you I watch your lives all the time, man, and you real like interactive with the people, man. You know whether you you're going there and play beats, or sometimes you just go on there and you just want to give a message real quick, or even go on there and start rhyming and shit. I'd be like, damn, this dude be going ham on the live. Right. But I enjoy that shit, man.
You ain't catch UG when he was
dancing? Nah, he ain't catch me dancing yet.
I'm gonna get one
this weekend though. Okay. I got one coming up this weekend. You know what I'm saying? Right. But like I said, that we pride ourselves on being that. Me and Finn, we pride ourselves on, like I said, the shows. You know what I'm saying? And just representing us and being able to touch people and get out there and get busy. The shows is most important for us. Besides the records and all that, the shows was number one, because we prided ourselves on going out there and whoever came after us, they better have made sure they had lions and midgets jumping out of cars and all, you know what I mean?
We made
sure of that. So
y'all tore it down,
tell you, you know what I'm saying? He said it. Even headliners got floored when we toured on Main Aim. He said it. So that's what we was about. You know what I mean? Just represent.
Yeah, hold on. Yeah, I think you on mute, bro. Let me I think Fantastic was talking.
Let me text him and tell him he muted. Hold on. Sure.
Yeah.
There you go. Okay.
That's a fact. We was on the road, we was giving a lot of headliners the blues.
Mm-hmm.
And how much love we was getting.
Yeah.
And doing records back to back. It was like, yo, these dudes kind of got it going on.
Yeah. Huh? Yeah. So real quick, I want to swing into Metabolic, you know what I mean, for the people that don't know, you know what I mean? Hold on.
Yeah. Yeah, sir.
What's that? He doing?
I got a part me, man. I'm in here on these buff. I'm on these buffalo wings, man. I got part me.
Go
man.
Ahead, get your
pop on. Here we go. Here got we me go. Hungry right now, man.
Shout out to my man Quan, all things Brooklyn. I shot that.
Ghostface killer, mint gone, I'm in pocket. Shorty's connected to my wrist like Apple Watches. Ink in, my ink pen calls prom limos. Bizarre memos coming barrage your demo, settle down. I pedal pounds of sound like sour. Public enemy flows, fight the power. And public enemies go despite the hour. I pull up on you
like this, boy.
Yeah, this is metabolic. The boy polished down to his bone posits. Up to his spirit, I'm with it to let the thing go. So many whips and chains, you think it can go.
Shout out to DJ Elohim on the cut.
Metabolic. I do this for barbershop. Then the plans up. Gonna have your plasma all up on your dashboard. The hands for the backboard. Track calls, look how they act, Lord. Fresh air forces, my land gorgeous, flow feed, I'm flawless. We record and put the board in a coma. When I'm chefing the mind, stomach, coma. This is metabolic, the metal holler put several up in your collar. Yeah, it's go time, they can see it like the 20-inch scene. Believe it, I'm back on down.
Oh, it's going down.
Yeah. That was right.
Next video right there.
Yeah, it's just me and my Cody. Go back and forth in OD.
Homie, you know we dwellers back to work. That's the next video right there. Y'all get ready for that. It's going down. As soon as my PNC come back from Vegas, it's going down.
Yeah, we about to get it in.
You know what I mean?
That was metabolic.
Is there dope, produced man. By Nick Wiz too?
Produced by Nick produced Wiz. That. So Nick Wiz, let me ask you, man. Compare recording. Compare recording now to recording back then, man. Which do you like better?
I mean, I like it when we in the studio together, which was back then. But now it's kind of like, yo, send me the beat.
Yeah. Less personal.
You know what? I mean, you get a lot more done that way. That way, you know, because most of the people that I work with that wasn't recording themselves, I showed them how to handle their business. And, yo, bro, it's been so much way more productive, you know. Yeah, we get a lot done that way, you know.
All right.
If I had the choice, we'd be in the studio together, you know. But
yeah.
With a Marvion running around, we can't do nothing.
I know. We got shit on lock right now.
Uh-huh.
I don't know if you guys have seen the Video Music Box documentary that Nas just put out.
I didn't look at the whole thing, but I was trying to get into it.
Okay. How impactful was Video Music Box to you guys' career in the beginning?
Tell him, PNC.
Uncle Ralph.
Super impactful, man. Super impactful. Ralph always showed us love from day one. He showed us love. We was at all Ralph events, block parties, Easter shows, everything he did at the Ark in Brooklyn. We did everything we did with Ralph in the early days. So we gotta salute Uncle Ralph, man, because he played a big part.
Uncle Ralph. Word. That's what's up, man. Yeah, I remember watching y'all videos, man. You know what I mean? The Goodfellas, you know, all your shit, man.
I don't mean to cut you, but Uncle Ralph used to, like, when we hit those events, Uncle Ralph used to pull up on us. Like, it wasn't just because we was artists.
Mm-hmm.
We used to rock with Ralph. Like, he used to be like, yo, we come here. Like, you know what I mean? So it was just family, man. Family.
Yeah, you seem like a cool dude. I mean, I never met him, but yeah, Uncle Ralph just seemed like, you know, like your uncle. That's why he
said that's what he was.
Yeah.
That's what he was.
Yeah. No doubt, man. So, I know you guys been keeping up or been watching the Versus battles and shit like that. Phantasm, who do you see you guys going against in the Versus battle, man? Or who would be your ultimate competitor in the Versus battle?
Ooh, that's hard. I'm gonna have to go Cellar Dwellers Das Effects.
Das Effects, okay.
Cellar Dwellers Smith and Wesson.
I was gonna say Smith and Wesson.
That
would be dope for the underground.
I think those two would be super dope lineups for us to do.
What about you? What about you, Up?
Anybody. Anybody. That's how confident I am in me and my pen. See anybody, Channel Blob, whoever.
Because the whole thing about it is after they get one of their two records off, that was they dope singles or hot, and it just goes down to performance and lyrics, it's going to get spooky after a while.
They're
going to have them first one or two singles that was hot at that time. Yeah. But when you go record for record, bar for bar, style for style, flow for flow, lyric for lyric,
anybody,
man, give a lot of them niggas problems.
Anybody,
yeah, because y'all bring a lot of energy in your show, man. And you see Jada Kiss, man. Jada Kiss took over the whole thing.
He like 2-0 by himself.
Yeah, right. Exactly. So. Yeah, a lot of times it does come down to just your bars and your performance. You know what I mean?
Right, other than having
them hit records. You know what I mean? A lot of cats go in there thinking that those hits is going to win.
It's going to save them.
See what happened to Dipset, right?
Yeah. Yep. You know what? I just think that they just weren't prepared to begin with.
You could tell with the locks, they were just more gelled together. And perform more. I don't care if Dipset performed or they rehearsed. It wouldn't have been the same because they not connected like that.
Yeah, that brotherhood.
They there on stage, but they not there. Yeah. Brotherhood wise, right. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And they got those kind of records that's good. It's good for radio and it's good hit records, but not every record comes off that great stage-wise.
Right. They don't always translate. Right.
Right. So it'll be good. It's a popular record. It sold a lot of units or whatever, but actually seeing that artist perform it and really get busy and can they hold their breath, can they hold their lyrics together? After a while, it's like, that wasn't really all of that.
Yep.
Yeah. But I would definitely love to see you guys in like a versus, you know, underground, like Daz, that would be dope, you know what I mean? Because they was, you know, straight from the sewer.
Mm-hmm.
You know what the problem is, man? Anybody. And you see my face? Anybody. Crazy?
Yo, because you guys, I feel like you guys are still bringing it, man. Can we expect to hear another, you know, Cellar Dwellers album?
I just got the green light from my PNC.
Yeah.
Nick Wiz, just before I brought the idea to him, Wiz said, yo, y'all need to stop playing. That was like 2 days ago. And then I called my PNC a day. He was like, I said, we might as well do it. Wiz said, we might as well stop playing. So, yeah, expect it.
Yeah.
And Christ just called me about a record, too, this morning.
See?
All right.
So, that's good, that, man, because he hit me.
That's going to be something new coming out real in a minute, too. So, we get a video for that, too.
Yeah, I like that how you guys still collab with guys that was, you know, that's from that underground, like, you know, like Rusty Cooks. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
How can the people reach you, man, if they want to get in contact with you, man, to check out your music or book you for shows? How can the people get in contact with UGG and Phantasm?
You can hit me on UG3111@gmail.com. You can hit me on UG_CellarDwell on Facebook. You can hit me on UG_CellarDweller on Instagram. And you can hit me at The Real UG on Twitter. You know what I mean? And you can hit me at UG_CellarDweller on TikTok too. We doing anything. I'm about to put up this Twitch channel in about a week. We rolling.
Hey,
I'm Phantasm CellarDweller on Facebook. And my Instagram joint just got hacked, so we shut that down for right now.
I saw that, man. I'm getting crazy. Like, yeah, you want to turn 300 and then the 30,000?
Somebody
got my boy. They got my man Phantasm.
Yeah, they got me. So I'm about to come up with something official Phantasm. I'm gonna come up with a whole new joint and let everybody know what's going on. But for right now, that's shut down. So
yeah, it's crazy. Right. I had to call my bro. I say, yo, bro. check your page out, niggas.
they got me when I was on vacation in Mexico.
Mm-hmm. I saw that. I was like, damn. Nick, where's, you know, how can the people reach you, man? Where can they find you on social media, man?
Just go to the Nick Wiz on Instagram. You know what I'm saying? That's it, really. I only mess with Instagram, which gets shared to everything else. So
right. I'm like the same way with the platform. So Nick, can we expect production from you on this album? And do you have any projects that you got coming out?
Man, listen, if the guys want me on there, man, you know.
He's honestly on there. He's on there. It's not even a question. He's on there.
Right now, man, I'm just doing a lot of, you know, outside of metabolic, you know, promoting that and doing all that stuff. Been working on a lot of TV and film stuff, like UG. Okay. UG and I got a placement. I mean, Fan got one coming up next year that we locking in. So, I mean, it's just some real dope shit, man. Series on Hulu. Like, we got, that's all I've been up to right now. TV and film is my home right now, man. I'm loving it.
I'm trying to dive all into that.
That's where it's at right now. That's where it's at.
This the rap dog. Tell them.
You see, the Wu-Tang has a series. I could definitely see a Cellar Dweller series or a documentary or something, man. You know what I mean? I would love to see that about, to come out with you guys, man. So yo, like I said, I just want to thank you guys. This was like a super duper treat. I did not expect this at all.
I told
man.
You, Gary Ganu. You know how we move. I told you it's gonna be different, man.
Once the general put the call in, you know we gotta respond. So you know that's the general. Yeah. So whenever you put the flag up, we coming.
I had to get my bros on here, man, because you know what I'm saying? They are part of this whole situation, even solo stuff. They all a part of it because, you know I'm saying, without them, it's ain't no Dwellers, ain't no UGG, ain't no Fan, ain't no. So we rolling, man. You know what I mean? So, I mean, so I had to call up my, and these is my brothers for real. This is not like just because it's music. We bros, you know what I mean? So it is what it is.
I can see that, man. So, yeah, I want you guys to keep doing what you're doing, man, and keep carrying the torch, man, for real. Boom bap underground hip hop, because hip hop is not dead. You know what I mean? The hip hop lives with the Cellar Dwellers and anybody attached and associated with that. You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
so,
sir.
Like I said, I salute to you guys. Anything that you got coming out, projects, I would definitely gladly post them and promote them on my page. You know what I mean? So I just want to thank you guys for coming on, man. This was a great way to end the last episode of the year, man. So I want to salute, man. Salute to you, man.
Yeah, you already know. I mean, but Gary, I'm going to send you all my information. Fan and Wiz, if they want to send you the information, they could. I'm going to send you all my numbers and everything.
I'm definitely on IG. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So that's pretty much where you can find me.
Got you. Got you.
Yes, this was dope, man. So got you. I want to thank you guys for your time and thank everybody out there in YouTube and IG land for watching the Gary Ganu Show.
Salute my brothers, Wiz, Fan. Stay safe out there, Brody. Don't spend too much money out there in Vegas, bro. I know how you do. Take it easy.
I spent about $850 in Atlanta. Don't hit me again.
Shout out to my bro, Nick Wiz, man. I love y'all, man. You already know what it is, brother.
Salute.
Yo, peace, fellas, man. Y'all be safe and y'all have a happy and blessed New Year, man. Like I said,
same we got to you, bro. Stay safe out there.
Likewise.
Do others drop their album? We got to have y'all back on here. And,
very soon. Very soon.
All right, man. So salute to y'all, brothers. Peace.